Hello, in this video we're going to be practicing locating the main idea of a passage that is clearly stated and also those that are not stated. The main idea in simple terms is a statement of what the author is trying to teach you. Good readers are able to synthesize and locate or infer what main ideas are as they read. Being able to do this is critical to improve reading comprehension. I like to think of the process as a mathematical equation. Topic plus the author's view or ideas equals the main idea. The first part of the equation is finding the topic, which is usually very straightforward. It's basically asking yourself, what is this passage or chapter about? The author's view or ideas relates to the purpose, tone, and supporting details that the author gives you. Thinking about both the topic and the author's view and ideas helps you be able to either locate a main idea that's in the passage or be able to determine what the main idea is of the passage if it's not written. We're going to practice doing this. So let's start off with a passage from OpenStax biology textbook. We're going to go ahead and pause the video and just read through this passage, and we'll pick it up after you've read through the passage. After reading the two paragraphs, I stop my reading and ask myself several questions kind of as I go. First, I ask myself after just these couple of paragraphs, what's the topic of the passage? So I'm thinking that in my mind. The topic of the paragraph, chapter, or a book is usually summed up in a single word or a very short phrase. So again, I think to myself, this passage is about photosynthesis and the grocery store. Now, I know what you're saying. That's right there in the title of this particular section of the textbook. Yes, authors often will clue you in to what the topic of a book, a chapter, or a subheading or subsection of a chapter is by the title they choose to use. So often that's a great place to identify what the topic is. So I now know that what the topic is. But does the author have a particular viewpoint regarding this topic? That's the next question I ask myself as I read. I also ask what reasons the author wrote the passage. What was his purpose? I think about the purpose, which is to inform me about photosynthesis and how it's connected to me in my life. I also think about the tone that the author uses. And when I think about tone, although we covered this in a previous video, I think about the emotion words that the author may have used. Is he trying to make me feel a certain way about the topic, or is it just kind of straightforward and neutral? To me, the article is pretty neutral. I didn't see any like real emotion words. He's really just trying to inform and give information. So the tone is kind of an informational neutral tone. The purpose is to inform me about how photosynthesis is connected to me. The tone is kind of an informational tone. And now I kind of put those two together and try to come up or see if the author just comes out and states something that, you know, is neutral as well as tells me what this whole thing was about. And for me, I find that actually written in the very last sentence of this particular passage. Ultimately, photosynthesis connects to every meal and every food a person consumes. That kind of encapsulates this whole couple of paragraphs from the textbook. Many times the main idea will be explicitly stated by the author, actually written right into the text. Authors can put the main idea at the beginning of a paragraph or section, in the middle, or at the end. It's really up to the author as to where they place that main idea. This selection, the author placed the main idea at the very end of the passage. There are occasions where the author will not state a main idea, and you'll need to infer or draw a conclusion about what that is. We'll discuss inferencing in greater detail in another video. In either case, asking yourself, what is the topic, what is the author's purpose in writing this passage, and what was the tone, can help you determine what the main idea is. Let's try another practice. In this practice, we're going to be reading an email. So go ahead and pause the video and read the email. I'm going to use the same questions I used in our last example. What is the topic? And does the author have a particular view on the topic based upon the purpose and tone? So emails, memos, or other written correspondence like letters will oftentimes use a critical or give you a critical clue to help know what the topic is. That's a subject line. And in this particular subject line, we can see that it's job attendance policy, so that I know that this particular passage or email is going to be about job attendance. So I know the topic. But does the author have a particular viewpoint on this topic? So let's look at the purpose. Well, based upon what I read, it seems to be trying to inform me and persuade me not to miss my shifts. Now, I look for a tone. Is there a tone in this particular passage? And yes, there is a tone. The author chooses to use words like abandoning, lame, fired, to set the tone of what he's saying. So I kind of would sum up the tone in one word as hostile or sarcastic or angry. Any of those would work. So combining the purpose, the tone, and the topic, I try to look for a statement in this particular email that sums all of what the author is trying to say up. And for me, I found it in the end of the email again. That last sentence, the gist of the policy is this: if you want to stay working here, show up for your shift. If not, you'll be fired. So that's the main idea. Let's try another practice, again, in a more professional version of an email. So go ahead and pause the video and read this email. So I hope as you were reading it, you were able to figure out what the topic was, the author's view and ideas, as well as came up with a main idea. But let's walk through it and see if we can find it. So again, I look up at the subject line and I find that the attendance policy, again, is what's being discussed in this particular email. Now, during the reading of the email, I am looking for the tone. Now, in this particular tone, the tone of it felt very professional, like business. It didn't use emotion words. It used more of a professional vernacular, like briefly summarize, circumstances. Instead of saying fired, they said possible employment termination. All of this was more professional. So the tone for me was a more professional tone. The purpose, again, for me was to inform me about the attendance policy and making sure that I don't miss my shifts. So I take the tone of a business professional tone. I take that purpose of me not missing my shifts, and I look to see if there's a sentence that kind of encapsulates all of that. And so for me, the sentence, all employees are expected to work their shifts unless prior arrangements have been made, really kind of summed up the whole passage for me with regards to this particular email. So that, for me, was the main idea. Now, if you came up with a different main idea, that's okay. You just want to be able to fall back on, well, the tone was this, and the ideas, the supporting details were these, and, you know, the topic and purpose was this, so that's why I chose this particular central idea or main idea. Let's go ahead and try one more practice. Sometimes authors do not explicitly state the main idea of the passage. Instead, we as readers must draw a conclusion or infer what the main idea is based upon the examples or supporting details that the author gives us. We'll cover inferencing in more detail in a later video. However, we will use the same process we used on the other two examples in this video to kind of work our way through to find the main idea. The big difference when an author doesn't include a main idea is we have to come up with or write out what the main idea is for ourselves. So go ahead and pause the video and read this short passage from the OpenStack Psychology textbook. So I'm first going to look for the topic of the passage. Now, this passage doesn't have a title. It just has the subheading historical perspective, but I don't know about what. So I have to kind of think about what I read to identify what the topic was. And for me, it stood out in that very first sentence, personality. And so for me, this passage covered personality was the topic. The next thing that I ask myself is, what was the author's tone? Again, to me, there was really no emotionally driven words in this particular passage, but it was more of a formal structure. It used, academic vocabulary like temperaments, behaviors, differences, theory. So I would say it's an informative or neutral tone. Likewise, the purpose for me was to inform me about personalities. So as I look for a sentence to summarize this whole passage, I don't really see one clearly stated that captures the whole paragraph. So I ask myself if the author's purpose was to inform me, what was he trying to inform me about? What was he trying to teach me? So I look at the ideas or the supporting details, which we'll talk about in the next video. That the author gives me. So he first talked about Hippocrates back in 370 BC. He also outlined Hippocrates' theory or the four temperaments or humors. He talked about Galen and how Galen built upon Hippocrates' work, and that his work, his theory, Galen's theory, lasted for over 1,000 years. So, based upon those supporting details, I try to come up with what the author is really trying to say overall. And for me, what the author was trying to say was that personalities have been studied for a long time and have traditionally been divided into four categories: sanguine, choleric, melancholic, and phlegmatic. So this seems to me to capture the meaning of the whole passage, although it's not written clearly anywhere in the passage itself. So when we infer, we have to come up with that based upon, the supporting details, the tone, the purpose, and the topic. So as you're reading over the next week or even throughout the day today, keep in mind the topic and author's view and ideas, and look for those main ideas as you read. It really will help you comprehend better. It'll help you learn more deeply. And in the next video, we'll be talking about the importance of supporting details, which is a related concept to main idea. And so until that time, enjoy your reading.